Hello friends, welcome in the session. Today I will let you know about how we can achieve a highly available architecture in which your application should be highly available and your data should be highly available. And how you can achieve a DR, how you can set up a DR, disaster recovery. Suppose if one of the whole region will got unavailable, so how your applications will be still available in another region. So that's the DR technique also. So in this class we will cover how route 53 failover policies will work, how to get the HA using active passive method, how traffic auto migrate from one app to another if your primary app got failed. Like if primary app health check failed, so it will be automatically move on into the secondary apps. And how to use the RDS master and read replicas. Actually, the RDS master is used to write your data, and read replica can be used only for the read purposes, not for the write purposes. How to set up it's a disaster recovery. How to promote a read replica as a master if your whole region got failed, if your whole region will be not available. So how you can migrate, how you can promote your read replica as a master. So to achieve the HA and to set up a DR, disaster recovery, we can use at least two regions. So what will be the two regions? We will first take a US East and US West. You can take two region, one region as in, so one region US East, and we will get the another region as in US West Oregon. So we have pre-set up a lab for that, in which we have created a cloud formation. So with the help of cloud formation code, our whole thing can be deployed. Our applications in terms of Elastic Beanstalk can be deployed through, automatically deployed through cloud formation. Our RDS automatically deployed through this. So this is, so what we have a setup. So through our cloud formation we have created a lab setup. In which we have a primary app inside a Elastic Beanstalk. So Elastic Beanstalk is one of the service that is used to deploy your applications. So this is in one region, and in the same region we have an RDS database. We have an RDS database that can be act as a master. So same thing we have in another region. We have deployed through the cloud formation code, we have deployed the secondary Elastic Beanstalk app, and in the secondary region we have an RDS, but with that RDS we don't have the master, we have the read replica. So this read replica can be used only for the read purposes. And this master can be used for read as well as for write purpose. Here there is no write options. Here there is no write options. So through the Elastic Beanstalk, we have deployed first primary app. Okay, and this Elastic Beanstalk will give you a URL. So this is a primary app URL. And from here, I will get, so I will give the name as in secondary app URL. So we will get both of two URLs. So let me show you the lab setup. I have already write the steps for you guys. I will put down all of the steps in our YouTube video descriptions. So first, go to the primary region. So my primary region is Virginia, US East 1. So from there, let me go to the Elastic Beanstalk. Go to the Elastic Beanstalk, copy the primary app URL. So click on the primary. So this is my primary app URL from here. Let me go to the primary. And here I will get the URL of the applications. So let me open it in new browser. And let me copy the URL here. Fine. So if you want to see like what type of instance I have used for that, so you can check in the description, as well as you can see I have deployed Elastic Beanstalk applications, and this Elastic Beanstalk application will give you a endpoint URL. If you want to see the instance types, what type of instances the Elastic Beanstalk actually, what the Elastic Beanstalk will do, Elastic Beanstalk will provision an EC2 instance over which it will deploy your applications automatically. So this is the EC2 instance that has been provisioned automatically through Elastic Beanstalk, and our application has been deployed there, and a URL will be provided by the Elastic Beanstalk. Fine. So I got the URL. Now you need to go to the RDS. You don't need to go, or you don't need to get the details of the RDS, it's just for the info. Like in the same region, I have the RDS also. So I have done a pre-configured lab setup. So under the instances, you will see we have an RDS instance and it's available right now. And what engine we have used, it's a MySQL engine I have used. So this is my instance type. So this is my engine instance type and its status is available. So all of the things is shown here. So I need the endpoint only. So this is my endpoint. So this is my primary DB. So go to the RDS instances, click on DB instance. So this is a master DB having replication in another region. So which is the another region? So this is my DB, this is my master DB. I got the URL of master also. I got the primary app URL. I got the master DB URL. And I have pasted it in a separate file. So this is my master. The whole content which my application has been written over the master has been asynchronized with the read replica which is running over region 2. And this read replica can be used by the secondary app. So I will come back in a while on the second app. So examine the secondary region. So let me show you the secondary region also. What is running inside the secondary region? So it's a US West origin. So what is running inside it? So first, let me go to the Elastic Beanstalk. So the same thing can happen here. Through the Elastic Beanstalk, an application has been deployed over the application, like over the EC2 instance, and that EC2 instance has been provisioned by Elastic Beanstalk, and your application has been automatically deployed over that. So I will complete the Elastic Beanstalk in next in any one of the upcoming classes. So it's totally regarding how the RDS failover policies and how we can set up a DR activity. How we can done a DR activity in your live scenarios. Go to the Elastic Beanstalk, click on a green environment box, click on a secondary. So this is my secondary app. copy the secondary app URL. So this is my secondary app URL. I have copied it. Let me copy it and open it in another browser. So it's giving me internal server error, but my primary app is running fine. Now I have copied the secondary app URL and let me paste it here. Fine. Now let me go to the RDS. So from the RDS, go to the service, go to the RDS. So what I need, I have copied the URL of primary app and the primary database master. And in the secondary region, this is my secondary region or US West Orient. From there, I have copied the secondary app URL. And now let me copy the endpoint of my secondary DB. So this is my secondary DB that can be synced with the primary region master DB. So this is my DB, this is the secondary DB. This is the secondary one DB, this is this one DB that can be act as a read replica, and it is in sync with the master. It is in sync with the master. First, the data can be written on the master, and the same data can be shown here within a milli fraction of a second on the read replica. Fine, so let me copy the endpoint of the same thing, and I have copied the endpoint of the secondary database. Okay, secondary database. Fine. Now what I need to configure both of the app in our route 53. Okay, so I have copied it. So now what I need to make a route, like if someone hit on my like example.com, so this URL should be coming on primary app, and if this the primary app is not reachable, so it should be going to the secondary app. So first go to the route 53, then we need to configure the health check. Health check only for the primary app. If the primary app is healthy, so our traffic will be routed on the primary app. If this is not healthy, unhealthy, so only on in that situation, if that is unhealthy, data will be routed into the secondary app. So let's go to the route 53 and set up a health check. So here are the steps. Go to your route 53, then create health checks. Name of the health check, I will provide this. So let me switch. Okay, I will not switch. Let me go to the route 53. I don't need to switch over region because route 53 is a global applications. It can be worked globally on for every region. So this is my hosted zone. So let me copy it and open it in the new browser. So still it's not serving because I have not routed anything in that. So this is my hosted zone only. So let's go to the health check. Set up a health check. Okay. So name of the health check. Let me give the name of the health check. Check-1 only. Fine. What to monitor? Endpoint, no issue. Specific endpoints, domain name. What are the domain name? I need to monitor our primary app. This is my primary app URL. So I need to monitor this URL. So health check, domain name, primary app URL I have given. Go to the advanced configuration requested in interval 10 and failed threshold 2. So advanced configuration. Wait, for the fast request interval, for it will check the do a health check for every 10 seconds. If it will got consecuted two times, like it not getting any reward, so it mark as an unhealthy. Leave all the things as in blank. Next, I don't need to set up an alarm, create health check. If you want, then you need to pass the URSNS and you will get a notification over the email or any other medium. So still the status is unknown, so no worries. Let's come on second step till it will do a health check and mark as healthy or unhealthy. So click on a hosted zone that already created. Create a record set. So we need to create two record set. We need to set a record set in which you will pass your primary app URL, and you need to configure a health check on the primary app URL, and you need to set up a policy. Like what policy will be used? We can use the failover policy here. Failover policy. So what are the failover policy? For the failover policy, we need to do a health check. It will done a health check on a primary app. Till the primary app is healthy, it will serve the traffic. It will route the traffic from route 53 to primary app. Once it will got unhealthy, so it got unhealthy, so the traffic will be routed, switched from here to this secondary app, and it will be done automatically. So let's go to the hosted zone and create a record set, a record to primary app. So my primary app was primary hype dot something. So this is the primary app. So I have routed this traffic. I have set up an A record, and once you will click on this, your traffic will be routed to primary app. And the routing policy is failover, and this is our failed record type is primary. Evaluate health target health associate with health check. Yes, evaluate target health. So what is the target? This is our alias target, so it will do a health check on the primary app target because this is my over target. Associate with health check, yes. Select a health check. So this is our health check that I have done. So let me click on a create. So I have set up a health check for that. So what I need to do, so once it got failed, like it's got unhealthy or primary app got unhealthy, so I need to set up a failover policy for the secondary thing. If this will got failed, so over traffic will be routed to the secondary app. So create record set alias secondary failover policy. It's a secondary one, so I don't need a health check, don't need to associated health check. So let me wait for some time. Let me check the health check. So our primary app is healthy. So I have set up a health check for both of them. For the secondary app, failover policies, record type is secondary, associated health check, no. Copy the secondary RDS URL. So this is my secondary RDS URL. So what I need to do, I need to update. So this is my app. So I need to update in that app, like which you need to connect with secondary databases. So I need to provide the URL of that RDS database into that. Still, it's not I have provided through the cloud Terraform or the cloud formation. I have not provided through the cloud formation. So in the secondary app, we need to pass the URL of the RDS so that this app will be reachable. So you can see our primary app is reachable. Let me refresh it. Secondary app is not reachable. I have set up RDS, and this RDS is going to be our primary app. So you can check version is 2.0 and this is our region 1, US East 1. The secondary app should be in the US West 1. Over RDS, we have set up the RDS and our primary app is still healthy. So it's over RDS, route the traffic to the primary app. So that's why over RDS, route the traffic to the primary app that is in the US East 1. Let me go to the secondary app on Elastic Beanstalk and setting up the DB as well. Let me go to the Elastic Beanstalk in the secondary region. Yeah, this is my secondary region. Go to the secondary app. So this is the Elastic Beanstalk. I have not configured that app with the DB. Now I am going to configure it with the DB and the parameter. What should I need to pass? Database underscore host is the parameter. Okay, fine. So database underscore host is already there, but value is not mentioned there. So I need to copy the secondary DB. Let me paste it into it here. Let me apply it. So once you will apply it, so Elastic Beanstalk is updating your environment. So it will take approximately 3 to 5 minutes. So once it will got ready, so it will give you from gray to green. It will change from gray to green, and a green right mark check mark will be showing here. So let me left it because it will take time. So I will do the next step. So once it will be reachable, then we do a test failover. Okay, fine. So once it will reachable, our secondary app will be reachable also. Now our secondary app is reachable. So we can see one thing. So this is our primary app, and the primary app is connected with the master DB in which you can able to read and write. So let me try to read and write. So I am giving the word. So I have given 1 word for airport, 1, 2, I have given 5 word. So let me give 10 word for this and 1 word for this and 2 word for San Francisco. So 10, 3, 2, 1, I have done it. So this is the primary app and this is connected with the master DB in which you can do anything on your app. It can be right on the master database. So that's why you are able to do these functions, but the go to the secondary app. So this secondary app is connected with the database, but this is the read replica. So this is the slave part of this master. And this can be used only for the read purposes. If you can try to write something into this database, so it will give you some error. So let me go to the secondary. So this is my secondary database. Sorry, this is my secondary applications. Let me refresh it. So you can see 10, 3, 2, 1. Let me do one more entry for San Francisco. And one more. And one more. So here are 5. Let me refresh it. So it will show you the 5. Why it's 5? Because you have write something in this database and it got synced with the read replica, and this application read the data from this read replica. So that's why it took fraction of seconds. So let me try to write something in this secondary app. Let me try to what it. So it's giving you an error. Degraded service. Why degraded service? Because this is the read only purposes. So this is connected with the read replica. You cannot do any write operations over that. So you can see this is the US West 2. That means 2, it's region 2. US West 1. This is US 1, like region 1. So both of the app can be deployed in different regions, and the DB can also be deployed in different regions. So this is my region 1, this is my region 2. Primary app can be deployed here, secondary app can be deployed here. Master DB can be deployed here, secondary DB can be deployed here. So suppose that, let's take an example of DR, disaster recovery. Suppose that the whole region got unavailable. So your app will goes down. So let me make your primary app unavailable first. Let me do a refresh. So still the data is coming from the primary app region 1. Primary app region 1. So let me make it unreachable. Let me make this region app unreachable. How we can make it? Go to the primary region. It's a US East 1 Virginia. Go to the app. Elastic Beanstalk. From here I go to the Elastic Beanstalk, click on the primary, go to the actions, terminate the environment. So I have terminated it. Name is primary, app name was primary, so terminate. I have terminated it. So once I have terminated it, it will go to the route 53. From the route 53, you can refresh it. So still it's terminating it. So let me refresh the whole page. Still it's terminating your environment. Once the termination has been completed, so you can see a health check. The primary app still it's showing unhealthy. Showing still healthy. Once it mark is unhealthy, once the primary app will be not reachable, it mark route 53, do a health check on the primary app and it will mark it as unhealthy. Once you will hit on a route 53 URL, once you will hit on your websites or domain name, so it should go to the region 2. Why region 2? Because primary app was healthy, so route 53 route the traffic to the healthy app, primary app. Once it will unhealthy, I have terminated it. Now the traffic should be routed to the secondary app. So let's wait for one more minute. Now you can see it take hardly 1 minute, less than 1 minute, and the route 53 mark the primary app as unhealthy. Let me check the primary app. My primary app is not reachable. Our secondary app is reachable. Fine. So the user will hit only on this URL. User don't know the primary app and the secondary app. Before that, it goes to the origin one. So let me refresh this page. Now it's go to the origin two, US West 2. So automatically the DNS failover will work. I have seen. But now let's take an example. The whole region is not available. It's a DR testing, you can say, are really a disaster. Region, whole region is not available. Your Elastic Beanstalk application is not reachable, or your RDS master DB is not reachable. So what you will do? Because in this case, your application traffic is got switched, but this is the read replica. So you user will not able to write anything into it. So you can try it from here. Let me try a vote. So it shows degraded service. Let me refresh the page. Let me again try to vote it. So it shows degraded service. So what I need to do, I need to mark this read replica as an master. Let me switch this read replica, promote this read replica as a master. So this is known as disaster recovery, DR sites. So we need to do it manually, because first for any DR, first we need to make sure that you need to do a DR activity. So we will check, like, once the region is not available, whole region is not available. So it take hardly, when you will migrate the read replica as a master, so it will take hardly 2 to 3 minutes. So for that we need some downtime in the DR activity, rather than the downtime for 2 or 3 hours. So what I need to do, go to the secondary region, then go to the RDS. So we have made all of these steps. Terminate primary Elastic Beanstalk app. I have terminated it. Route 53 health check shows failed. Yeah, Route 53 health check shows unhealthy failed. Wait until it got unhealthy. Now you can find, like, this gives an error, degraded service. You have migrated the service. Now the service has been migrated automatically, but you need to change, promote the read replica as a master. So I'd go to the RDS, go to the secondary instance, select instance action, go to the instance action, and promote read replica as a master. Go to the instance, select the secondary one, click on secondary one, go to the instance actions, promote read replica. Yes, automatic backups, continue, promote read replica, yes. Go to the dashboard again, instances. So here it's modifying, like, it's changing the read replica to the master. So what it will do, how it will change, it will terminate your read replica, it will terminate it and create a new thing with the master properties. So your reboot time, your promote read replica to master, is also depending on your master type. What type of instance you have used for that? Like, I have clicked on a secondary, so I have used t2.medium, because this is only, I have used this only for the lab purposes. But in the real time environment or the production environment, it might be possible that this is a large instance type, so it will take less time. So let's wait till this migration from read replica to master will be completed. So I will pause the video till that. Now the instance has been terminated, rebooted. Now it's backing up. After backing up, it will be reachable and make up. Now status got changed from backing up to available one. So let me refresh, or user may refresh this page. So this is my secondary app. So still it's going to be the secondary app one, because primary app got failed due to this region is not available. Okay. So what the issue we are facing at that time? Degraded. If user will try to watch something, so it will show a message degraded, because this is a read replica only. So I have migrated, I have promoted it to the master. So now the user should be able to watch it. Now this is my app 2 in a region 2. So let me refresh the page once again and try to watch it. So you can see it's going to be updated 11, 12, 13, 14, or let me check, do what for San Francisco, 8, 9, 10, here go the number goes change, 11. So that means you have migrated, or you can say you have migrated the whole thing, application as well as your DB, from one region to another region. So this is known as disaster recovery. If one whole region, I'm not talking about the zone, there are more than two zones, zone A and zone B. So there are more than two zones in a region. I'm not talking about the zones, I'm talking about the whole region got failed, like both zones, and if there is three zone or four zone, so the whole region got failed. At that time, how you can migrate the whole thing from one region to another region? So that is known as DR. That is known as disaster recovery. So we have set up a failover policy, right? How to get HA using active passive method? We are getting from failover policy. How traffic auto migrated from one app to another app? We have seen if this app got unhealthy, traffic will be routed to the secondary app. How to use RDS master and read replica. Master is used for the read and write purposes, but the read replica can be used for some analytics purposes also, for the read only purposes. How to set up a DR activity. So we have seen how we can set up the whole infrastructure to get the HA and to get the DR also. How to promote a read replica as a master, we have seen it also. So I have done a lab setup with the help of CloudFormation. So that's why I have deployed the apps with the help of Beanstack. So hope guys you enjoyed the whole class. So thank you very much. So please like, share and subscribe my videos. It will give me a lot of motivations. And one more thing, if you will go for an like advanced architectural official training on the AWS Amazon end, so this is the this would be your lab second. So in the whole course there are only 5 labs. First lab I have already uploaded. This is our second lab. So I have not shown any AWS content because this is a prohibited. I have done my own setup. So guys, please like, share and subscribe to get more videos. Thank you.